fellow reading warriors, and welcome to today's video. So right now is currently the beginning of May. It's still within the first week of May, and so I'm going to share with you my TBR and kind of talk about this month's genre that I've chosen. So this month's genre, I chose for it to be science fiction, because I do like science fiction. I know that I do. Considering quarantine, I haven't really been able to go out and get books or go to the library to get books of other genres, so I thought that this would be just kind of a month to read all the books on my shelf that I have not been able to read, that I've been wanting to. So that's why this month is science fiction, and I am choosing to keep it science fiction, and that's why I didn't talk about it in my last April video to kind of give you guys a heads up, because I didn't know if it was going to change or not. So one other thing that I do want to mention is when I buy a book, it's a loan, like it's not clear that it's part of a series, I am really bad at looking at it and seeing if it's meant to be part of a series, like if it's the first book and more coming out later. So a lot of books that I own are first books in a series or in a trilogy or in a duology or whatever, and then I never buy the rest of the series because I haven't read the first book yet. So I have a bunch of like first book of this series that I haven't read, and then I don't have the rest of the series because I don't know if I'll like the first book or not. So that's the thing, is that's what a lot of these books are gonna be. First book in a series, and I'm gonna read it. If I like it, then I'll buy the rest of the series. If I don't, then we're gonna unhaul it. And at the end of the year, I do want to do an unhauling video of all the books that I finally read and didn't like, or just didn't think it was good enough to keep on my shelf, especially considering I will be moving back to Minnesota if quarantine is over, because we have an apartment. My fiance and I have an apartment over there, and we're getting married over the summer, so it's going to be our first home together, and it's a very small apartment. So I'm gonna also do another video about transporting books, because I have some different ways that I like to move my books, especially since I have a lot of books and not a lot of space. So that will also be another video. Comment down below if you're excited for either one of these, or if you have any requests about them, like, oh, can you talk more specifically about this, or if you want to hear how I do this, or blah blah blah, whatever, go ahead. So that all being said, I'm gonna get into the TBR for this video. The first book that I'm going to read is called Invictus, and it's by Ryan Grodin. I can't pronounce names. I'm so sorry, authors, if I'm constantly saying your name wrong. I'm so sorry. This book, I don't know too much about this book, because in here there's a letter to the reader, and it says, if you don't like time travel books, read this book, because it's a time traveling book that you're actually gonna like. And I just immediately stopped reading there, and I was like, I don't have a problem with time traveling books. I do not mind them, but I do not read a lot of them. So I really hope that this is good, because I prefer watching something with time travel than reading, just because it can get confusing if I'm not sitting down and reading it like all in one sitting or in one day or very close together. The thing about this though is that what I think is going to help me get through it is that I got this as an audiobook. So even though I own the physical copy, I will be listening to the audiobook, so hopefully that'll help me have a better, I don't know, understanding, or, you know, I'm more likely to be able to listen to my audiobook throughout the day as I'm doing things or as I'm driving places. I mean, I'm gonna get a delivery job, which is really gonna help my audiobook consumption. But yeah, so I'm gonna start off with this one as an audiobook, and this will be the only one that I do as an audiobook, because the other ones were not available on the apps that I use, and I just don't feel like flooding my phone with all different audiobook apps yet. I'll get there, but not yet. The next one that I have is Alive by Scott Sigler. This one, as well as the last one, Invictus, were both books given to me by a friend of mine's mom. Originally, way before they came out, years ago, but I just have not read them, and I feel really bad because I was supposed to help her. I am going to be reading this one as well. This one is about a girl and a bunch of kids, actually, who wake up in coffins, and they have no memory except for what their names are. And so this girl that we're following is one of those girls, and she feels like she's the leader, but she doesn't know why, because she's not the biggest or the strongest or the smartest, but like for some reason everybody is following her, and so they're trying to figure out like why they're in the coffin, which sounds kind of mystery-y. This sounds like a mystery slash thriller, But Goodreads said it was a science fiction, so I think there's something about it that's gonna make it sciencey and fictiony, but we're gonna have to find out as I read it. And yes, and as you may have noticed with a lot of my TBRs, I do not give very good descriptions of books before I read them, because I don't like knowing a lot about them. Like, I hear people give summary of books, and it's like, you just told me the first half of the book. You're like, oh, it's about this person, where this happens to them, okay, that happens in the first 50 pages, okay, and then this happens, and then this happens, and then I'm not going to tell you the ending, and I'm like, you basically just told me every other part of the book. So before I read a book, I do not like knowing a lot about it, so my TBRs will be horrible, but I can give better summaries after I've read them in due time. The bummer is, though, so while Invictus, to my knowledge, is a standalone book, this is the first of a trilogy. I don't have the other two of the trilogy, so if I like this, maybe I'll get them. If I don't like it, maybe I won't. So that's the details of this book. Moving on is I'm moving on to a book that I've technically already started, but I started it again at the beginning of May. Like, it was like May 2, and I was like, oh, I read the first like 5 chapters. I'll just reread the first 5 chapters so it can be the entirety of this month. And that is Thunderhead by Neil Schusterman. This is the second book in the trilogy, and as you can see right here, I do have the first book. I do not own The Toll. I do not own the third book, but I get the feeling that I'm going to want to buy it and finish it. Yeah. So I've technically already started this one, but it is like May 9, so I mean, I had to get started, even though I didn't quite have time to film this video. I'm on chapter 10, which is page 89. Hey, 89, my dad's favorite number. Anyway, so I know about this one going in, and it's a sequel, and I really liked the first book. I think what I would like to do is I would like to finish this, and then read The Toll, and then kind of give like a trilogy review. So I'll review the first book, this book, and the last book all in one video separately, and then also together as a series. But I will read this one for May, and I will let you guys know what I think of this one, but I gotta say, I'm liking it already. And I was just super excited for this. Like, when I finished the first book, I was like, oh my word, this has to be a series. And then, lo and behold, the second book came out, and I was like, oh my gosh, it is. So I bought it. And then The Toll came out, and I just haven't bought it yet, because I haven't finished this yet. So, that's probably gonna be what I read first, just because I've already started it. But yeah, I'm super excited. This might be my favorite one, calling it now. Favorite one. I have 2 more books on this TBR, and the next one is also something I can't grab. The next one is also a book that starts a series, and I don't know if there are like 3 or 4 books in the series. I don't know if it's a trilogy or 4. I looked this up like a little while ago, and I just can't remember for some strange reason, and that is The Thousandth Floor, Catherine McGee. The Thousandth Floor by Catherine McGee. I remember I went to a bookstore and I saw this and I was like, oh my word, this looks so cool. And I think it was on like the bargain shelf or something, even though it had come out kind of recently. And I was like, oh, this is so cool. I like the sound of it. You know, the higher you are, the farther you fall. But it's like the higher you are, the like more you're respected, or like the more parties you get to. I don't know. You get a better status the higher you go. But also, the higher you go, the farther you fall. So I'm like, whoa. And this follows a bunch of different kids as well. Like, each one kind of has their own backstory and how they're all trying to climb. I started reading this one once upon a time. There's a little bookmark in there you can see. So I did start reading it, but that was when I first got it. And then I got distracted because I think I had bought multiple books at the time. So I started reading something else and I put this down. And I never picked it back up again. But I know I liked it. I know I was interested in it. So I'm gonna, again, try and start this one. See if I like it, and if I do, if I can't get the rest of them. So yeah, that is already one trilogy with the first book. Another trilogy / series, 3 or 4 books. And then I'm reading the sequel to another trilogy. So that already is like a lot this month for me to handle. I think really what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna read each book that I have here physically, and then if I like them and I want to move on with the series, I will wait until I've finished all of the books, just so I can get this TBR done, get the books that are already on my shelf done. That all being said, I do have one more book on my TBR. It's a book that I own on my Kindle. It's an ebook, but I have bought it, so it's not like a library book on my Kindle, and it's another start of a series. Technically, it's the start of a trilogy, but there are 5 books in this trilogy, so if you don't know what it is already, how? So that would be The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. This is a book that I've owned on my Kindle for a while now, and I've been really wanting to read it. This is by Douglas Adams, by the way, in case, again, you didn't know what I'm talking about. Yeah, 5 books in the trilogy. My brother owns all of them, and he is so proud to say, I own all 5 books in the trilogy. Because it sounds weird, because it is weird, but that's because, you know, that's Douglas Adams' style. He only wanted there to be 3 books. He was pressured into writing a 4th and a 5th one by, like, his editor or his publisher or something like that, and he wasn't super happy about it. But yeah, no, so, like, I own the first one. My brother owns all 5, so if I like it, I'll just borrow them from him, because he does let me borrow his books. My brother's an interesting person because he has very few books, but the books that he has, he's read over and over and he loves very passionately. And he's like, oh, Laura, you need to read it, you need to read it, you need to read it. And then I do, and I'm like, okay, let's find another book to read together. And he goes, no, I don't like reading. And I'm like, what? It's so confusing. Anyway, so I haven't read Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, and I really feel like I need to because it's so random that I feel like I need to, but I also don't generally like random books. So this is going to be interesting for me to read, but again, I have it on my Kindle, so it's going to be much more transportable, but it's not like I'm going anywhere, which is a bummer. But this is how I own it, so it's how I'm going to read it. That is 5 books on my TBR. It is already 1 week through May. I've started one of them very briefly, but 4 of them are in series. Only one is a standalone. So, and the one that's a standalone I'm listening to is an audiobook. So this is going to be a very interesting month. I don't know if I'm actually going to be able to read them all or not, but I'm certainly going to try. Because here's the thing. Last month, for my OWLs, and those vlogs should be up by now because I'm going to air this at the end of May when it's all one completed video. And the OWLs, I'm working on editing now and getting them up as soon as possible because it's already 1 week into May. Anyway, side note there. Those, I was literally reading 400 page books, one a day. But the thing is, I stayed up late to do that and I didn't like it, but I always set a 2 a.m. bedtime. And I was always able to sleep in the next day, but I don't like doing that. I am not a morning person, I'm a night owl, but I do not like sleeping in super, super late. But I do not like staying up super, super late because I don't like sleeping in super, super late, but I would rather stay up late than get up early. So, my point is, I'm trying to read 5 books in 4 weeks, and I have classes, and I'm gonna have a job. But again, we're quarantined and I'm taking less classes, and so I'm hoping that I can do this. Basically, so what I'm trying to say is that I really hope that I can do this. I'm gonna try very hard. Yeah, and that's why I'm making this video, this part of the video is to hold me accountable. Because I say I'm gonna read these 5 books, and potentially more afterwards. And by golly, I better read these 5 books and potentially more afterwards. So that should be it for this beginning part of the video. Like I said, I'm gonna try and make it a little bit vloggy, but still super uncertain on what everything is gonna look like with quarantine, with working, with school. So we're just gonna kind of be on the tip of our toes and be ready for whatever comes. I hope your reading journeys are a little smoother than that. So yeah, this month is science fiction, and I've got that with immortality, time travel, alive, somehow, I don't know. I'm kind of including dystopian in science fiction, in case you couldn't tell, because I think The Thousandth Floor is dystopian with, like, it's got advanced technology in there that we do not have, so that's why I'm including it in science fiction. So we've got that, we've got time travel, we've got immortality, we've got spaceships, and we've got whatever makes alive science fiction. So, with that, I am going to see you guys later, probably at a later date, after I've, like, significantly read one of these books. So, bid you adieu. Hey guys, what's up? It is May 13, and I'm coming at you with a update on the books I've been reading. So, as you guys know, I've been reading Thunderhead by Neil Schusterman here, and I'm, like, 100 pages in. Yeah, 125 pages, and I've been reading this really, really slowly, but I've also just been, so happy because I finished my first year of university. I just finished that semester, and I started doing my summer classes, and I'm starting to get a handle on those, so I have a schedule again. And so I've been reading this really slowly because I've been trying to get things done, but things are done now, so I expect I'll be reading this much quicker, especially because I am enjoying this so much. I'm like, it's interesting because they add another character in the second one that you don't know of, and he kind of comes from, like, the Thunderhead representative, but, like, things happen. I don't want to spoil too much, but it's, like, it's nice because it's not just, like, a repeat of the first one when you're following the two apprentices and then after the competition, but, like, they're adding in another element, so it's, like, we're continuing on with the same story because I really enjoyed that story, so I'm very happy, but they are adding another element to it so it doesn't get boring or repetitive, so that makes me excited. I am gonna try and read this very quickly. I'm gonna try and finish it this week. So that's my update on that so far. Still loving the characters, still, like, super excited to see where it all goes. But then I also started reading Invictus, and this is by Ryan Groudon. I'm gonna guess that's how you say his name, not really sure. I started listening to this as an audiobook, but I am also considering, like, sitting down and reading it just so that it gets done, but that's probably not gonna happen. I'm probably just gonna read this on audiobook, and I am almost a third of the way through this. It's about a crew that kind of works on the black market. Like, they go back in time and they take artifacts to bring back to their own time for their boss to sell on the black market. And so while that's an interesting concept, to me it is still a time traveling book, which I don't have a problem with, but I don't know why, so I don't read a lot or watch a lot of time traveling things. Like, I guess I'm a fan of, like, Doctor Who, and there's also a little bit of time traveling in Harry Potter, which I didn't mind. It's a classic, like, time traveling novel. I don't care if they're stealing artifacts for the black market or if the guy was born outside of time. You're still jumping from time to time, from place to place. It's a time travel book. But it is really good. It is really interesting, and I am excited to also finish listening to it or reading to it. And the next one that I'm going to read after I finish the two is going to be Alive. So that is the bookish update for now. So I will check back in with you guys after I've done some reading. Hey guys, so it's been a while. It is now May 21st, and I finally have some updates. It's kind of interesting because how it happened was that I didn't have much of an update, and then all of a sudden I finished two books at once, and I started another one, so it's like, yeah, I didn't have much to say, and then all of a sudden I now have a ton to say because I finished two books and I've started the third one. The first book that I finished was Thunderhead by Neil Schusterman. This is the second in the Ark of the Scythe trilogy. I finished this and I immediately got on my laptop and bought the third one. I was trying not to buy books during quarantine, just because the work to buying books ratio was kind of non-existent, but I cannot help myself, and I just need the third book in this trilogy, just to complete the trilogy because I do like it, but also because this was one of those ones that had an ending with a bang, and so it was a great kind of lead into the third book. I really enjoyed this one. I'm giving it 4 out of 5 stars. There's a quote in here that I think really does sum up the Scythe-thumb. It's said by Scythe Curie, and she says, "It's high school with murder." And I thought, that's so true, because, like, it's political, but not in the sense of, like, politics that really make that much of a difference either in the future or for other people. You know, it's very political within themselves, but because it can't influence the Thunderhead or really other people as much as it influences them, it really is kind of like high school, especially since so much of it is, like, petty and, like, people are taking sides of like old scythes and new scythes and this new ideas that are coming to scythe them and just so it was really interesting. I really agree with that statement and I liked it a lot. That being said, of course a lot of it is petty. I don't know. I say it works. I like it. I really love the character development that's going on in here. Obviously you have your main characters, and they're getting character development, but even some of the less focused on characters are getting character development, and especially towards the end, and I really appreciated that. I really liked that because sometimes side characters are what make the novel or break the novel. So like if you actually pay attention and care for your side characters and actually give them development, that just warms my heart and it makes me happy. I definitely root for that completely. Normally, I'm not a big fan of politics in books, just because I generally have a harder time keeping them straight, but I really enjoyed them in here. Yeah, it really just, it went out with a bang. It was just consistently good. I was consistently wanting to keep reading it. It really brought in some new characters. Like, it's still focused on, like, Rowan and Citra and the Scythes and everything, but it brought in new characters and new locations, which was really interesting. Yeah, it kind of got to be a lot because it's like, there's this new storyline and plotline that we're following in, and then there's this new storyline and plotline coming in, and now you're following, like, four or five different points of view, four or five different, like, storylines, and they all tie up in the end, except, no. One of them did not tie up at the end of this book, and I think that's because it's going to tie up in the third book, which is why I'm super excited to read the third one, is to really understand what was going on in that line. But, like, it started to get to be a little much, like, when you have five different situations kind of going on, all playing into each other, it's a lot happening. But other than that, I really enjoyed it, and I'm giving it 4 out of 5 stars because it was really good. We continued to develop this world. And, like, so in the first one, I'm just... book everywhere. In the first one, Scythe, you were reading out of the journals of the Scythes, while in Thunderhead, you were reading from the Thunderhead, which was really interesting, because the Thunderhead has a personality, kind of. Like, it is super alive, you know? Like, it honestly kind of makes me think of Data from Star Trek, and how, like, there was that whole episode of, is Data human, or is Data not? Like, should Data be treated like human and not? Like, it seemed like the Thunderhead was at that level of AI, because he was able to be, like, talking to us readers, but I don't know, it was kind of weird. I liked the concept of them doing that, but meh. So I'm intrigued to see what the third one will be, what we're going to be reading from at the end of every chapter. So yes, I finished this 2 days ago on the 19th. I finished it late at night and I was like, oh my word, I can't believe it. I literally sat there and ranted to my fiance about the end of it because I was like, oh my, because he hasn't read them and he's not going to read them. It's not his genre of book. And so he was like, okay, I won't understand anything, but go. And I just spilled all the specifics of the ending, which I'm not going to do here because I want this to be a spoiler-free review because it is popular and because if you guys like science fiction, I really encourage you to read it. But it was just like, I just sat there and I was like, oh my word, and then this happened, and then this character did this, and oh my word, this happened, blah, 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 blah. And I just went on and on for a while. So if you want a spoiler-filled review, let me know, and I can definitely share my thoughts more specifically on, like, the ending and the events that took place. But for now, this is what we're gonna go with. And then, obviously, the other book that I finished was the other book that I was reading, although I was listening to it as an audiobook, and that was Invictus by Ryan Groudon, I believe it's said? I don't know. But it's interesting. So this is a time-traveling novel, and it was interesting. I liked it. I rated it 3 out of 5 stars, though, because, like, it wasn't, like, a bad story, but it just didn't quite capture me or entrance me in the same way that, like, Thunderhead did or other books that I've read have. But it was still, like, a good book, and I would still recommend it, especially if you like time travel. The one interesting thing, though, about this is that... So this book was published in 2017, and the characters take a little trip into the future, except they don't go far to the future because I can imagine when you're writing a time traveling and you want them to go into the future, you either want them to go really far into the future to like a place that you know no one's really going to be reading this book and comparing it to the future, or you want it to be very close in the future where it's like not enough has changed so that the book can still be accurate. But it's funny because he puts it 3 years into the future, specifically April 19 of 2020. And they go to Vegas, and they talk about how all the people are there, and there's parties, and blah blah blah, and I'm like, you know, I don't think that's actually what happened April 19 of 2020. Because we were all in lockdown, because there's a pandemic going on. And so it was just really funny that this book that was published 3 years ago tried to put the characters in a near future, so because the book thought, or the author, you know, thought that things aren't going to change enough, so it's going to be okay, except that we got a pandemic. So, like, it's super not accurate. It's super inaccurate, and it just cracked me up, because I was like, oh my word, this was, like, a month ago. Like, literally, I finished this on May 20, so I finished this yesterday, and I did a lot of listening to it the day before, and I was like, oh my word, it's actually 1 month after when the characters were supposed to go to Vegas, and I can almost promise you, it was not false. It was false. It was completely fiction, and it blew my mind. It was so funny, because it was like, little did you know, that's not gonna be accurate when you thought it was gonna be accurate. So, that to me was just a really funny occurrence, just because, like, you assume so much. But anyway, one thing I really did appreciate, though, was each character kind of had their own little thing, own little quirk, own little, oh, this is Graham's thing, or this is Prius's thing, or this is Farth's thing. And every time they started a ship log, they had that. So it was like, the color of Imogen's hair, the song that Priya is listening to, Graham's touch of score, and then it said Far's ego. And I was like, you're not measuring his ego, though. Like, they weren't saying, like, oh, he's so full of himself right now, or, oh, he's been humbled. Like, no, it was just, like, Far is annoyed. And I'm like, that's not his ego, because we all get annoyed. So, like, I admired, and then as Elliot joined the crew, like, she gets her own. So, yeah. Like, that was really cool about the independent characteristics of each character. The ending was kind of eh. I mean, like, I liked it. Kind of how it happened here, I'm gonna put this down. Kind of what happened was there was a big climax, and then there was a resolution to the climax, and then there's that little bit extra afterwards, like most books have. Normally, I don't like that little bit afterwards, but that's just me. I gotta get over that because so many books have it. But it was interesting because, like, I was fine with the big climax ending. I like how everything was wrapped up, but I did not like that extra little bit at all because, like, what was happening shouldn't have been happening. And it's gonna be really hard for me to explain this without spoiling things too much, but it's like, if you are born, you can't have memories of people you met before you were born. You know, like, okay, and that's the tricky thing about time travel. It's like, so this guy lives his life, and then when he's born again, like, he lives his life, and then he changes something about his birth. And then it's like, throughout that little section where it's like, okay, and this is him growing up again, he's like, oh, I feel like I know that person. I'm like, you shouldn't. None of this should seem familiar. You weren't even born when all this was happening. Like, they were just like, oh, I think this was a thing once upon, or this seems oddly familiar, but I can't place what where. You shouldn't be able to because you were not alive. Like, no! So, like, I think what I hate most about time traveling books is that they will just make it seem like, oh, I remember something from before I was alive. Like, no. Ah, no. That disturbs me a lot. I do not like that at all. It's so cheesy, it's so bad, and that's not how it goes. That's not how life goes. That's not how this all goes. And then my only other thing was that, so, when they're doing this job, this new character kind of barges in on their team, and her name is Elliot. She is sent to do something, and she has no problem with it. And I'm like, you would have some psychological trauma or like some emotional problems with that. So yeah, there were just some things that were like unrealistic about things and time travel and how it all works. But I mean, I still think it was a fun story, you know, like them going back into time and doing things, and yeah, it just did not impress me at all or wow me, or yeah, it was just kind of flat. It was like a flat good. So that's kind of what I thought of that book. And then finally, I started Alive by Scott Sigler. I am 70 pages into this 345 page book. I like it a lot. It's moving a little slow right now, so I'm really hoping that it picks up. Because if it doesn't pick up soon, it's gonna end up, I'm gonna read this like a day or two before May ends, and I don't want to do that. I want to finish it like now, like by this weekend, before this weekend really starts for me. I want to be able to finish it. It's a quick read. The chapters are super short, which I don't know why, it just makes it such a faster read for me, and it makes me super happy. And it's pretty large print actually, so it's like, theoretically, I should finish this very quickly. If it just picks up the pace, it will be great. But I like the introduction to the characters, and yeah, it's mysterious. So that's all for this update right now. Yeah, I'll update you either when I'm partway through Alive or when I've finished with it. I'm also thinking of starting The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy soon. I'm on hold for the audiobook of it at my library, but I do own it as an ebook, so I'm wondering if I want to just kind of sit down and read it on my Kindle and then like finish Alive, or you know, I'm just wondering how I'm gonna do that, if I'm gonna read Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy during the day and then Alive at night or whatever. Just so that's kind of where I'm headed now, because I only have like just over a week to finish Alive, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, and read The Thousandth Floor. And then if I want to, try and read The Toll before the next month, because as soon as June starts, I'm gonna be moving on to the next genre, and I won't really have time to continue reading these series that I'm starting right here. So yeah, it's like the year's gonna be done, and I'm gonna be like, oh my word, now I get to read all of these sequels and all of the rest of the series of the books that I started this year but didn't finish, because I own too many books on my shelves. That's not true. I don't own a lot of books. Like, this plus one section of the bottom shelf is it. Like, over there, games. Over here, games. Up here, Harry Potter. Like, it's just this. but it's like, I wanted to get all the books on my shelf read. So I wanted to get all the books on my shelf read. Yeah. But I don't own the entire series of most of these books. Most of these books I own the first book, or the first and the second one of, so it's like, I need to read all those before I can finish the series. I don't know why, but because the libraries aren't open yet, that's how it's gonna be. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this update, and I hope you're having some good reading. Hello, hello, hello. It is Saturday, May 23, and I am sitting outside in front of my dad's garden there. He's starting one. My neighbors are playing music as they're working outside. It's a nice warm sunny day, so I've been wanting to be outside. I kind of took a day off and I've just been focusing on things here at home. So yeah, I am reading Alive by Scott Sigler. I took the cover off. I took the dust jacket off because I really like this. I think it's really pretty. I love the contrast of the black against the light blue, kind of teal almost. So I have 100 pages left in this book. I read all the way up to one third of it last night, and then this morning I woke up and I read another third of it, and now I've been reading a little bit, but then I was like, oh my word, I should give an update because I am about to sit here and finish this book. Like, that's gonna be the goal. I'm gonna finish it today because I have 100 pages left. I would like to sit here and finish it, but if that doesn't happen, I'll for sure finish it tonight. So I really like it so far. It's kind of reminding me of Maze Runner vibes, like, a lot, because it's literally like these people wake up with no memory except for their last name, and they thought they were 12, and it's their birthday, but then they're like 19, 20 years old, And they're wandering around this ginormous building, and they just like, yeah, they've been wandering from room to room, finding more coffins, more dead bodies, more bones, dust, you know, it's like this completely abandoned place. So it's giving me, and they're kind of like putting together this little tribe of all the people, you know, they're figuring out leader and they're finding tools and weapons and things like that. So it's like really making me think of the Maze Runner, you know, they're trying to find their way out, trying to find the grown-ups, figure out what's going on while having little to no memory. So, but I am enjoying it. I think it's just a little slow in my opinion, but I also just really don't like slow books. Even if it's like slightly remotely slow, like it annoys me a lot. But yeah, so far I'm enjoying it. So I will update you guys. Yay, yard work. I will update you guys later, hopefully when I finish it. Okay, so I decided to move into a shady spot because it got hot outside, and yeah. And look who joined me!
Bonjour!
My fiancé came out to join me, and now he's even reading the book I'm letting him borrow.
Slowly but surely.
Yeah, he's reading the Sabrios trilogy. He's almost done with it too. I'm really excited to hear what he thinks because both me and my brother love it. So I'm really interested to hear what he thinks. And he's going to read the next one, so we're super excited. Mm-hmm. I have one chapter left in my book, so I'm definitely going to finish that today.
Epilogue.
You're on the epilogue! Yay! Mm-hmm.
Almost there.
Finish first.
Almost
yeah, you're probably going to finish before me.
Mm-hmm.
But,
haha.
So yeah, that's just a little update. I will film again when I finish the book and can give a full overview of my thoughts.
Bye, internet.
Okay, so it's May 26th, it's 3:30 in the afternoon, I'm at my fiancé's dad's house, and I'm in a closet, because it gives me Harry Potter vibes. It's this cute little closet that's got a stair with carpet, and I don't know, it just seemed like a great reading place to me, I don't know why, but I'm thoroughly enjoying it. So much so that I finished the first book in The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Initially, I was reading it on my Kindle, and then my brother came over and he gave me all 5 books in one. That's what this is all 5 books. But I finished reading the first one. So if I finish The Thousandth Floor before the end of May, I'm going to try and read more of these. but yeah, so I just wanted to give a quick little update. I enjoyed it. It's definitely crazy, and you just kind of have to let a lot of things go if you're a very logical person, but it's very easy for me to do that because I'm not super logical, so yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna rate it. I'm thinking 3 out of 5 stars, but I did kind of enjoy it. I might still just give it 3 out of 5, but yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about it. Maybe I'll talk about it more in depth at the end, but pretty simple, pretty straightforward anyway, so bye! Okay guys, it is Friday, May 29, it's about 5:30 in the afternoon. The Thousandth Floor by, it was like Catherine McGee, there we go, and I started it and I read the first 50 pages, and then I had a lot of time today, so I read the next 250 pages, so I'm actually almost done. I'm like 2/3 of the way into it, and I'm hoping to finish it this weekend. I think I will. I will finish it before June, pretty much. And it's different than what I thought it was gonna be. I went into this book thinking it was going to be a dystopian kind of look at society and where society is headed, because it's this building where, like, the higher up you live, like, the more richer, or, you know, the bigger parties, and the more drama happens. And so I thought it was going to be like a critique on society and hierarchies and social class and things like that. But it's high school drama mixed in with that a little bit, but not a lot. Like, there's a little bit talking about the discrepancies between living up in like 900 floors versus like more the 100 floors. But there's not really much about it. Like, it really is more about these teenagers and the dramatic lives that they lead, and kind of them being friends but also jerks to one another, in my opinion. The thing about this is that each chapter is told from a different character's perspective, and it kind of bounces back and forth between characters, but it has a large cast, and so we've got like four or five characters that we're bouncing back and forth between. And so to help me keep them straight of what name matches with what storyline, I have ranked them of who my favorite characters are and who my least favorite characters are. So it's like, okay, I am reading from this person's perspective. Where are they on the rank? Okay. Oh, they're this person that had this thing happen to them, or they're responding to this thing in this way. So yeah, it's just a lot more drama-filled. But like I said, I still have another like third of the book to go, so I'm hoping that it changes and kind of gets a little more serious. But otherwise, I mean, don't get me wrong, it is a page-turner. I am reading this very quickly, and I am enjoying and just wanting to read more and more and more of it. But I wish that there were some more stronger themes rather than like high school drama with relationships and people not knowing how to have good relationships. So that is pretty much all I have to say, honestly. It's the last book that I have to read for this month. Then I will have read, I think, all the sci-fi on my shelf, which was the goal. So, yay. I did order The Toll, and I don't know. I might try and read The Toll next month just because I want to finish the trilogy, but yeah. So speaking of next month, my June TBR is going to be its own video because I've decided to participate in a readathon, and so I'm making the readathon TBR video, and that's going to be its own thing. I do not know if I'm going to vlog very much during this readathon because life is busy and I feel like my vlogs have been pretty dry. Or like, it's really not very interesting, so I'll probably do more like what I do for these, where I give an update after every book that I finish, but I wouldn't say it's super vloggy. June, I will say, is my fantasy month, and initially that was going to be a placeholder. I was going to switch it out for another genre, one that I had thought of. That was going to be more of books that I don't read, because I do love to read fantasy and sci-fi, and like honestly sci-fi was a placeholder for this month as well. I had 2 months where I was gonna switch it out depending on like what I needed and what I liked, but because of the pandemic and me no longer having access to a library and work kind of being messed up, I just took to what do I have on my shelf that I haven't read and should, and that was a lot of sci-fi and fantasy. So that's why I did not change these months to a genre that I do not read, because I wanted to get these books done and off my shelf so I can either keep them, know the story, and like them, or I can unhaul them if I wasn't interested or if I do not finish them. So that's the update for now. The next time I will update you is when I have finished this book and kind of done a full wrap-up of all the books that I read for me. So yeah, I'm gonna say goodbye for now. So it is Sunday, May 31st, the last day in May. It's just past 8 o'clock and I just finished The Thousandth Floor by Catherine McGee, and this was the last book on my TBR for this month, and I did it! Yay, and I even have a couple hours to spare, so I mean, I don't know what I'm gonna do with this time, but I'll find some book to read or something to do. But yeah, so I just finished this book. I own the first one, and then there are two more in the trilogy, and I have a hard time with this book because so much of it was very high school drama, and the only reason there really was a story was because people wouldn't communicate with each other. So it's a very character-based, character-driven story, but so much of it was just high school kids being dumb and stubborn and just not talking to each other about their problems with each other. And so I think I had a hard time with that because I do not like petty high school drama. So I mean, so I wasn't super thrilled with that, but at the same time, it was still good writing and it was still a page turner. Like, every person had a secret and every person was doing something wrong, and that was annoying, but at the same time I just couldn't help it and I kept wanting to read it, which annoyed me because it's like, I don't like that kind of thing. but let me read more. So that's kind of what I was getting a lot of with this book overall. I found it being where, because it is such a character-heavy and character-driven book, near the beginning I had which characters I like more and which characters I don't like, and that pretty much did not change a lot throughout the entirety of the novel. But I kind of wish that it was a little more focused on the, like, social hierarchy of the building a lot more than it was. I was hoping for a little bit more of a hard-hitting kind of critique on society and how we value money and earthly objects and, like, you know, having clothes and keeping up with the fashions and all of that, but it didn't focus on that as much as I was hoping. So I'm wondering if it will in the second book, because there wasn't really much of a cliffhanger. It was just kind of a, there are still secrets being held, and yeah. So I don't know if I'm gonna read the second one. I think I will if I don't have anything else to read. But again, still a good book. Might read the second one. We'll just kind of see where life takes me, honestly, on that one. And so with that, I finished all my books for May, and it's the last day of May, so, like, yay. I'm just gonna go ahead and do a full wrap-up of all the books that I read, which one was my favorite, and kind of their ratings and things like that, so I'm gonna get right into that now. So in total, this month of May, during my sci-fi month, I read 5 books off my shelf, which I am pretty happy with, considering I ended school, started school, got a job, and moved around a lot. So I'm pretty happy with that. I read Thunderhead by Neil Schusterman, which is the second book in the Arc of Sight trilogy, and I did order the third book, and it should be here in a couple of days. I rated this 4 out of 5 stars because I loved it. Normally, I don't like the second books in trilogies as much as either the first or the third, but I really enjoyed this one. So if you read the first one, you're gonna have a great book to look forward to, in my opinion. I then read Invictus by Ryan Groudon, and this was my first time reading any of her books, and so I enjoyed it. I'm interested in reading some more of her works. It wasn't my favorite book. I think I also rated this one 3 out of 5 stars because I had a few, like, nitpicky problems with it, but I still think that, you know, for a time travel book, it was still pretty good, pretty interesting. Again, it's another character-driven one, but I ended up loving these characters a lot, this cast. Each one was very unique, and so I really appreciated that in this story, so this was a good time travel. The next one that I read was Alive by Scott Sigler. This is also the first book in a trilogy, and I might pick up the second one. This had a very interesting twist at the end, which at first I wasn't game for, but then the more I read, the more I was like, okay, yeah, I do like this. I think it was a little slow at first, but otherwise it was good. I think I also rated this one 3 out of 5 stars. So this one is where kids kind of wake up in these coffins or boxes or whatever, and they have no idea what they're doing there and no idea why they're much older than they thought they would be. So this is a very good kind of mystery sci-fi that I would still recommend, definitely. Next up, this one's gonna be a little deceiving, but I read The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. I read the first book in the trilogy, which has a total of 5 books, although the last book is like, what is it, like, not 14 pages. I don't know. It's not a lot. It's barely a 5th book. I have all 5 of them right here in this copy because this is my brother's copy. I initially started reading it on my Kindle. Again, I rated it 3 out of 5 stars. This is just a 3 out of 5 star month for me. I don't know. It's one of those books that you love because it's crazy. But, I don't know. I enjoyed it, and I'm glad I read it because it's, like, it's going to be a classic, or it is a classic, but it just didn't thrill me as much as I hoped. But this was kind of my space travel book, and I also will probably continue reading this series because if I don't, my brother will attack me. No, he won't want his book back until I finish it, so this thing is, like, it keeps flopping back and forth. Anyway, so I read the first one in this one. And then finally, I read The Thousandth Floor by Catherine McGee. This is the one I just finished. It was also rated 3 out of 5 stars, just because it wasn't what I was... It isn't the kind of book that I generally enjoy, and I didn't quite understand that going in. But again, I would still recommend it. Like, just because all these books, except for, like, the first one, was rated 3 out of 5 stars, does not mean they're bad. Like, I will generally still recommend a 3 out of 5 star book to people. It just means that there are a couple things that I had problems with or didn't like or think could have been better, as well as not having that special X factor that made me, like, super emotional or super attached to the book. It's very rare for me to give out 5-star books, but I do actually give out 5 stars to some books. It's just very hard for me to get there. So 4 stars, kind of my normal, yes, this was a great book, I loved it, there just was missing that special something, but otherwise it was great. So 3 stars is me one step below that. I still enjoyed it, I would still recommend it, but I just had some things that just made it not quite one of my favorites or, like, a great book. I will probably still keep most of these on my shelf. I will probably keep them all, because I will still have 3-star books on my shelf. The question is, since so many of these were beginnings of series, the question is really if I'm going to go out and buy the rest of the series and read the rest of the series, because if I'm going to do that, then obviously I'm going to keep the book. But if time passes and I find myself still not interested in picking up the second book or the rest of the series, then I will most likely unhaul it, because I am sick and tired of having all these books that are the beginning of a series and not the rest of the series on my shelf. I'm finally reading them to know if I want to buy the rest of the series and read it, or if I just need to say goodbye and give it to someone else who will enjoy it a lot more than I will. So I'm very happy that I got that done this month. that was very exciting for me. Next month is June, and next month is my fantasy month, but I'm also going to take part in a readathon that I recently found and was interested in. So actually, I took my June TBR of the fantasy books I was interested in and kind of wove them into this readathon while adding some more books that I was hoping to read but didn't think I'd have time for, but now that I'm doing a readathon, I magically think I have time for them all of a sudden. So if you're interested in watching that video, it's actually going to be the Olympic Games June TBR, because that is the readathon I've chosen to partake in. So that video will be up very shortly after this one, hopefully. So if you're interested in June's TBR and the fantasy books I will be reading, that's the video to go and watch. I don't think I'm gonna do as much of a vlog with these as I did with the OWLs, just because times are crazy and I just got a lot kind of going on my plate right now. So I will still, like, film after I finish a book and my thoughts and kind of a wrap up at the end, but I don't think I'll do as many vlog clips about my life or reading. But if you guys don't like that and you really do want me to include more of a vlog or lifestyle in it, then comment down below letting me know, and I can certainly add some clips in that would be fun or entertaining to watch. Otherwise, comment down below letting me know if you've read any of these books and what you thought of them, or if you've been inspired to read any of them, or if you have any video ideas that you want me to do over the summer. I'm hoping to do more fun videos like tags and challenges and different things like that, so I hope to do that, so feel free to comment down below. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you found it to be interesting, entertaining, or educational in any way. Also, feel free to subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified when I upload, because I am doing one genre per month throughout this entire year to kind of expand my reading tastes and figure out what I like and what I don't like. So if you want to follow me along that journey, then hit the subscribe button. I will always have something per month for that, and then I may add extra fun videos on top of it, time allowing and health allowing. So with that, I'm gonna say that's the end of this video, and I hope you're all staying safe, staying healthy, and I wish you happy reading.